Hello, Vulcan community. We are so excited to come to you today, Sage and I. We have been having wonderful conversations throughout the break. As you guys are having a break, so are we. But for us, when we get a bit more downtime, we become very creative and we become very passionate about this time of the year. And both of us know very well what Christmas can bring, like all of you, with family, with all the chores, with coming out of the work synchronicity and coming out into this more natural flow, or for some of you it may be a little bit more chaotic in regards to the fact that everybody's wanting your time, attention and energy. So Sage and I wanted to jump in and give you guys some quick 5 points from each of us on our tips for navigating the Christmas chaos or the Christmas extravaganza, whichever it is for you. And we're just going to go through our points each and have a little bit of a discussion, keep it short, sharp and shiny for you. So enjoy, pop your comments below, whatever you're thinking and feeling. Maybe you've got some stuff that really works well for you, or maybe you've got some situations or ideas that you need a little bit of navigating with. Feel free to pop them below the recording, but I'm going to jump straight in and let Sage go for it with her top five tips. Thank you so much for joining me, Sage.
Thank you, Sharna. Okay, top tips. These are in no particular order, and these are just the little things that I find helps me on any holiday, but particularly applicable to this Christmas time when we're eating and drinking a whole lot more than usual. So the first one, I always try to go to bed and wake up at the same time if possible. And in saying that, even to eat at the same time. So if you're going to sleep and waking up at the same time, a really easy meal to have at the same time is breakfast. And that just helps with your digestion. Going to bed and waking up at the same time helps with not only, for me, falling asleep, but also helps with my energy. So I always make sure I try to do that where possible. The second one I'm really anal about is keeping hydrated. It's not always important for us activators to stay hydrated. Yep, there we go. Good girl. It's very important for diplomats to stay hydrated. So get the hydration in early, but that's a major one that I find really helps. The third one is to keep moving. I tend to keep the morning routine the same. So go to bed at the same time, wake up at the same time. I go for my walk at the same time. This is another good one for crusaders because it just helps you to clear your mind. So walking in the mornings when I get lots of really great ideas, but it's also good to keep the mind calm, particularly for the crusaders as well. For the diplomats, guardians, keeping moving, it might mean just a brisk walk after lunch or even just an easy walk after lunch, just to keep the body moving. That's my third tip. Fourth tip is to choose healthy foods when it's easy. So when we're out and when there's all those tempting foods around, that's when it's a little bit more difficult to choose the healthy foods, particularly when your favorite foods are there. So choose the healthy ones when it's easy. So if you're at home and you've got the option to have the healthy food, that's when it's really easy for you to choose the healthy food. So be quite disciplined, choose it when it's easy and the tempting food's not around. Not to go YOLO because, say, for example, I know tonight I'll be drinking champagne, so I don't go YOLO. I'm going to blow my calories out today anyway, so I'll just eat what I like. I'll keep the food consistent and choose the healthy foods right up leading to this evening when there's not going to be as many healthy foods available. In saying that, though, we're bringing share plates. So the last point is when you do have to bring food, choose some healthy foods to put on there. And for example, tonight I'm bringing a cheese platter. So that's not always healthy, but I'll make a healthy dip to put on there. I'll cut up vegetables as well. So when we're bringing, share food, choose some healthy foods to add to it. Even if you're making salads, pick a salad from Shea to take with you. So if you're bringing share foods, then you've got a healthy option to bring. And then there are some healthy foods there as an option for you as well. So they're my top five tips in no particular order, and they're the things I find really help in any holiday season. Over to you, Shana.
Love that. I'm going to quickly tack on to that one with the share plates and the foods. Be the rebel at the party. Be the one who, like, there's always going to be the people who bring the terrible food. So just don't join that one. That becomes the norm at these parties. Be the one that brings the more express, the more healthy and balanced thing. And I definitely have a tack on to that is an 80-20 rule. So when I go out, I'm the same. I'm an endomorph. I'm a diplomat. So I'm very sensual. I'm very much about wanting to have all the things. I don't like to be told I can't have something because then I want it more. And I don't like things like that to be taken away from me. So I choose an 80-20 rule. 80% of my plate is all of the good choices and the stuff. I fill my plate with the salad that I brought that I know is good. And then around the plate, I have the taste of everything. I don't go without anything. I still have everything, but I just choose to fill my plate in a way that's much more beneficial and much more happier for the stomach and whatnot. So I'm very similar to Sage in quite a few of them, but a few to tack on around that would be being outdoors as much as possible, especially creating that as family time. Your family time and outdoor time, a lot of you work indoors during the year. So you spend, you know, a good 80 to 90% of your life in a building or in a car. So use the Christmas time to really get outside and connect with nature and connect with your family. We were created outdoors, and unfortunately throughout our evolution we've gone indoors. And so use this time, get out there, get the rays, get the earth, touch the earth, play with the plants, play with the kids, laugh, play, be silly, get in touch with your silly self, and enjoy that time. It's a physical detox, really. The other one is using the Christmas. This is more for the endomorphs, because I know that amongst this entire community, there are a lot of you that during your working week are awake way too early. So I really implore you to bring that family time and this sleeping regulation is to spend the Christmas time and try and bring yourself back into slightly closer to your chronobiology, that colored wheel that you have in your app. Try and bring yourself back as close as possible to that time. Use it as like a sleep detox. A detoxing from the poor habits during the year of just getting by and getting through the working year, and use this time as an opportunity to really detox and bring the body back to its natural state, which, leading into the food choice conversation, will actually directly link. If endomorphs are choosing and craving and binging on poor foods, 98% of the time it is that you are not getting enough sleep and you are not getting enough outdoors, hence my 2 points so far. So that's a big one, because I know that we have a larger, wider community of the endos in here, so I thought I'd tap into that. Sorry, everyone else, nothing against you. You've just got added benefit. I also recommend using the Christmas time to clean out the house. You are in home. It is your direct environment. Even though you're out doing parties and whatnot, you go out there and you give all the energy and you play and you do all of the stuff. Come home and make sure that your home environment is as nurturing, clean, tidy, happy, glorious as you possibly can, and make sure that it brings you joy. If it doesn't bring you joy, fix it quickly, because this is where you rebalance and regain and re-nourish yourself the most. And the other one for me was number five, beverages. So I've got German heritage, so I could drink most of you under the table. Yep, really could. But that was the old Sharna, and I know that Sharna very, very well. So I know that I actually play ahead, and I do things like I brew up my chai tea and my rooibos tea, and I'll brew it up in liters, and I will actually pop that and chill it down to, well, for me, room temperature. For some of you, you'll want to have it cold. But I have that with me, and I might mix it in with some soda water and a fresh squeeze of juice of citrus or something like that, or some apple slices. I made one the other day and added soda at home, and it was absolutely fantastic. It stopped me from drinking too early, and I spent a third of the day not drinking and having my iced tea. I had some drinks around the main party time, and then I finished off my night again with just some soda water and citrus. So that was a really good way of me doing that. And then also ensuring that you have a gargantuous cup or bottle that you have when you get home, or when the party guests leave. If you're consuming this, and many of you will argue that this would then lead to you needing to go to the toilet a lot. Good. If you are out partying and eating poor food choices, lots of sugar, lots of alcohol, you're not going to sleep the best anyway. And I'm sure most of you already know this. You actually won't sleep the greatest when you've been doing these things to your body. So you may as well do the right thing and fill it with a heap of good hydration, good quality water. If you don't have a filter, get yourself a Christmas present and go buy a filter of some kind to assist with that. Make sure it's good quality. But really do your best to hydrate before you go to bed, because the headache the next day will be horrendous if you don't, and your digestion the next day will be horrendous if you don't. So that's a definite must for me and for all of you. So I hope that helps you all. We did want to keep this short, sharp and shiny. Sage, do you have any pointers to add to that?
Yeah, just one to clarify, as far as sleep timing goes, my sleep already adheres to my chrono, which is why I keep it the same. It appears to be a little bit of a contradiction there. So yeah, if it's not adhering to your chrono, definitely, as Sharna says, try to stick to your chrono in that Christmas time, really just to take some of the stress off the body and give it a chance to recuperate a little bit. Mine's already in my chrono, which is why I try to avoid the late nights. Even if I do have a late night, I'm still up early and going for my walk. Because that will ensure that I sleep better the following night. So just to clarify a little bit there, and then just one thing to enjoy yourself. If you plan to have some of your favorite food, plan to have it and enjoy it. That will ensure you have a regular sized serving. If you feel good about the food that you love, you don't actually you're less likely to overindulge in it. You're more likely to have a reasonable serving, feel positive about it, feel happy about it, enjoy it. And then you're less likely to say YOLO and just eat everything in sight because you're going to feel positive about it. So remember to have a break, especially for the guardians and the diplomats out there. You love your food. So allow yourself to have it, enjoy it. Don't feel bad about it. Have a regular serving and give yourself a little bit of a mental break around this time as well. That's really, really important, I think. So that's my final extra point, I guess. You're off the hook for a little bit.
Perfect. Exactly right. So guys, enjoy your Christmas time. If you get the chance, post up some photos of the food or the family stuff or the outdoor stuff, whatever it is. We'd love for you to share and inspire each other. And also potentially I give you the challenge of making me jealous of your wonderful expeditions and partaking, because I think it really raises the vibration of the group. It raises the energy and the thoughts of the group. So enjoy the time and share it. So thank you all for jumping on. We look forward to your feedback and your thoughts.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Yes.
Bye.
Bye.